My God is awesome. He can move mountains, keep me in the valley, hide me from the rain.
I got Jesus. I got Jesus. I got Jesus. I got Jesus. I'm alive. I'm alive. I'm alive. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. The Bible says that we all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and that the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. That means when you were born, you owe God something. Oh, God bless you. God bless you.
Praise Jesus.
Praise Jesus. You owe God something. You know what you owe him? You owe him your life. And you know what the Bible says? He who loses his life for my sake will gain his life. But he who tries to hold on to his life will lose his life. And you know why? Because if you try to hold on to something that doesn't belong to you, if you ever been in a bad relationship, if you ever had a bad boyfriend or a bad girlfriend, and it's just time to part ways, it's just time to separate, it's just time to go your own way, and you keep trying to hold on to it, you end up losing part of yourself. You end up losing your hair because you can get stressed out. You end up losing your mind because you're holding on to something that you shouldn't hold on to, you should just let go. You can lose your friends, you can lose your credibility, you can lose your reputation, you can lose a whole bunch of things when you hold on to something that you need to let go of. I'm here to tell you today, you need to let go of your life. You need to let go of your life and relinquish it to Christ. You need to let go of your life and relinquish it to Christ. Because there's no eternal life in yourself. There's no eternal life in your flesh. There's going to come a time, there's going to come a day when you will have, when you will be called home, when your spirit is going to leave your body, and when your spirit leaves your body, where are you going to go? Where are you going to go? Well, the Bible says this, that the Bible says that you have one time to die and then judgment. The Bible says to be absent with the body is to be present with the Lord. And the Bible says that anyone that's not found with the mercy of Christ, anyone that's not found in the Lamb book of life, will be cast out to outer darkness, and there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. We don't want you to weep and gnash your teeth. We want you to have life and have it more abundantly, because this is what Christ Jesus says. Christ Jesus says that it's not his, well, God says it's not his wish that any should perish. It's not his will that any should perish, but all should come to repentance. It's time to repent. It's time to get right with God. It's time to turn your back on the world and turn to Christ. It's time to turn your back on death and turn to life. It's time to choose this day whom you will serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Let's go.
What is the NGO? What is the NGO?
Okay, let me ask you this. I mean, tell you.
There are four books. I will come to the point where NGO. There are four books. And in the Quran, they are mentioned by their name. The first one is the Torah, which is for the Jewish. Injil for the Christianity, Zabur for the David that you're telling me, and Quran, which is the Quran for the Muhammad. Those are the four books.
Okay, so what is the Injil? I asked you what, so you don't know. I'm going to assume you don't know now, because I'm going to ask you one more time. What is the Injil? What is the Injil?
The Injil is the book that was preached by Jesus Christ, but it was lost because people didn't want him. They wanted to be destroyed. They wanted to be killed. And what happened is, they caught him, they wanted to hang him on that cross, because during the time, that cross was the capital punishment during the time.
Why did they want to kill him?
It wasn't like the Romans.
Why?
Yeah.
Why did they want to kill him?
Because they claimed that even Muhammad wanted to be killed. You know that?
Brother. So basically you don't know what the Injil is. I asked you. That's wrong. I said, what is the Injil?
You don't know what you're talking
about. Injil means good news. What is the good news?
You tell me.
My wife was Muslim. My mother-in-law is Muslim. My sisters-in-laws are Muslims. I have a whole Muslim family, bro. That's how come. And they speak Arabic. And they show me what's in the Quran, and that's how I learned this. So that's where I got this from. Now look, Angel. Listen, brother. I know you're angry. But it's okay. Get mad at Allah. Don't get mad at me. I didn't write this stuff. Now look. What I'm gonna ask you again. If okay, if you don't know, bro. What does Injil mean? Why did they call it? It's good news. So tell me what the good news is.
No.
It's not a book, bro. It's not a book.
Okay, let me have that.
What is the good news?
Let me give you the answer now.
Injil is the book that was preached by Jesus. Okay, but it was lost. I'm telling you.
It's not a book.
It is a book.
No.
It used to exist during the time, but it was gone because they destroyed. That's what I'm telling you.
Injil means good news. So look, let me explain to you what the good news is. It's not Injil is not a book. It's a person.
Okay.
Listen. Injil is not a book, bro. It's a person. A person, bro. The good news. This is the good news that Muhammad robbed and stole from y'all, and the Quran stole from y'all. Is that Christ came down. He was killed, buried, rose again from the dead, ascended to heaven for everyone's sins. Now that's the good news. And that's why Moses didn't have any good news. That's why David didn't have any good news. That's why Muhammad didn't have any good news. The only person that was worthy enough to be called the Injil was Christ Jesus. And the good news is that salvation has come to all mankind. That's the Injil, bro. It's not a book. It's not a book. It's the gospel. Injil in Arabic, good news in English, and the gospel in Greek. Just means good news. It means the good news of Jesus Christ. That's what you're missing. That's why you don't understand. That's why you say it's a book. And one more thing. This is how you know that it's not a book that was lost, because the Bible says, "Oh Muhammad, if you have any doubts, resort to the people of the book." So the book can't be lost if he's telling you to resort to us to teach you about your scriptures. Oh Muhammad. And it also says, let the Jewish judge by the Torah. Amen. Amen. Which one? Right here, amen. Injil refers to the gospel given to the prophet Jesus. Both the word Injil and gospel literally mean good news. Amen. So Muhammad says, if you doubt anything, resort to the people of the book. So why would Muhammad tell you to resort to the people who don't even have the book anymore? That's asinine. Another thing. Last thing, and I'll give it back to you. Then he also says that if you have any doubt, resort to the people of the book. And also says that let us judge. Let the Christians judge by the Injil. Let the Jews judge by the Torah. So why would he tell us to judge by something that is no longer in existence? That's asinine. That would be silly. And once again, if you were a Christian, you would know that the Injil is two things. It's a book and it's a man, because the Bible says in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That's why this is a Christian. He doesn't even know the Word.
Okay, let's go back and argue about the Bible and those who wrote. Do you know, this is the truth now, do you know that Bible the Bible was written Moses. Bible came after. You need to learn the history because Moses came before Jesus. Moses came. But how can...
The Torah is written by
Moses. But anyway, to become a Muslim, you have to believe in those books. All right? Thank you, brother. Yeah.
Who wrote the Torah? Moses wrote the Torah.
No.
He wrote Genesis.
He did not. Go and look on that movie. You did not.
Hold on, it was written.
Let me tell you this. Let me tell you this. The Bible you're talking about. Listen to this. The Bible. Okay. Give me one second.
Any imam will tell you.
You don't have to become an imam to know Islam. You can become an imam also. You can become a knowledgeable person. But you need to read. You need to read it for the fact. Yeah, see? Let me tell you this.
You must know Arabic at least.
Why
you gotta do this? Why you gotta come here?
Don't confuse. Don't confuse him or me.
Can I just say one thing? And then I'll talk some more. Exodus 17:4. This is on subject. I got you, bro. Exodus 17:4 says this. And the Lord said unto Moses. Now listen. This is the Old Testament. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book. That's Moses.
Moses.
God said to Moses, I'm going to read it again. Put my glasses on. Maybe it don't say that. Yeah, let me say that. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book, and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua, for I will utterly put out of the remembrance of the Amalek under heaven. So actually, this is the Pentateuch. So God actually told Moses to write in the book. So we actually have proof in the Bible that says God told Moses, write this down. So wait, are we clear on that?
Okay, what I wanted to also to understand is that the Bible that you're talking about was written 600 years after Jesus Christ was... 600 years! Yeah, 600 years after. So my question is, if someone was not there 600 years ago, how can you...
How long was it written?
600 years before, after Jesus Christ.
How long?
600 years.
Who taught you that? Who taught you that, bro? Because you know what you guys do? You know why I say that? Because look, you guys are just regurgitating what someone told you. But if you do study, listen, the book of John, listen, so look, the first gospel was written, listen, the first gospel was written in 30 AD. That's 30 years after. The second one was written in 33. The latest gospel that was written in 60 AD was the gospel of John. So there's no, it's not. Listen with your ears, not with your mouth. You've been doing that all day. So that's not true. The Gospels, matter of fact, we have papers, we have papyruses that date to tell you exactly when it was written, and they date to 30 AD, 33 AD, and 60 AD. I don't know where you got this 600 years later. That's why I said, who taught you that? Because that's not the truth. You got that from YouTube?
And who found those?
Your YouTube channel.
Guys, everyone go watch his other videos. It's on Christ forgiveness. He actually always gets like exposed. He gets proven wrong a lot. And yeah, I want you guys to go watch more of his videos because he gets proven wrong a lot.
Yeah, continue your video.
Yeah, I'm glad.
This video
is everyone, I'm not from Christ Forgiveness Ministries. As you can see right here, I guess this guy thinks all black people look alike because that's not me. Actually, I'm from the Ministry of the Word. So, sorry, I'm a wrong person. Maybe all black people look alike to you, which is racist. But once again, right here, it says loud as day, I'm not from Christ Forgiveness Ministries. I am not from Christ Forgiveness Ministries. I am from the Ministry of the Word. So, I don't know what that guy is talking about, but you're lying. Once again. So the Bible says this. The Bible says, bro, let me ask you a question. Who taught you this nonsense? Who taught you this? Be honest. You probably got it from YouTube while you're talking on you preach your gospel. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in it will not perish but have everlasting life. You know, if you accept Jesus Christ, you don't gotta be embarrassed like this. It's embarrassing trying to defend the Quran. It's embarrassing trying to... We haven't even got into Muhammad. Like, if I were to get into Muhammad, it's so embarrassing trying to protect or trying to defend everything that this guy did. So that's why the character, the sinner of Jesus, is greater than Muhammad. The sinner of Jesus is greater than Allah. The sinner of Jesus is greater than the Quran. It's the sinner of Jesus. That's why even the Quran even says Jesus was sinless. He was flawless, the Quran says. So why not follow the sinner of Jesus, what is greater than the Quran, greater than Muhammad, greater than Allah, greater than all these other sinners? Why not just follow the sinner of Jesus? The Bible says that you suppress the truth and unrighteousness. Why do you do that?
Repeat again. My mind was
there. I said, why do you reject Christ? Is Jesus a liar?
No.
I'm asking, is Jesus a liar?
Okay. No Muslim can reject Jesus because we have to believe in him to become a Muslim.
He said he was going to get crucified.
Who? Huh? Who?
He said he was going to get crucified.
Who?
Jesus.
No.
Yeah, see, so you're rejecting
it
right there.
No.
You're rejecting it. Right?
Show me where? Show me where? Show me in the Bible, right?
No.
Which Bible?
No.
Which version? That's what I'm saying. There's so many. And one thing. One thing, there are so many contradictions.
Show me one. People always say there's so many contradictions. Where'd you learn that? You're talking from YouTube, bro. You're not. Show me. No. That's it. Show me. No, I want you to show me. You said there's a contradiction in the Bible. Somebody got a Bible? You got a Bible? You got your Bible on you? If you just show me a contradiction in the Bible. I want you to show me the contradiction in the Bible, bro. You said that there's contradictions in the Bible. Show me one. Here's the Bible. Wait, I'm gonna give you the Bible. You're gonna need the Bible, bro, to show me. Look, here's the Bible. Wait, wait. Okay, I'm gonna give you the mic. But let me recap. You said there's a contradiction in the Bible. I'm gonna give you the Bible to show me the contradiction, but instead you want the mic. So there's no contradiction in the Bible. You can't prove what you're saying. Can you prove what you're saying? Can you prove what you're saying? Okay, you can't show me. You can't show me. If you can't show me, show me. No. You made an accusation. Found your accusation.
No.
You can't. So you're saying you made a mistake. Okay, humble yourself. You made a mistake. Okay, so here's the Bible. Show me the contradiction. Show me the contradiction. Okay. I didn't bring up the Quran.
We don't argue like this.
Okay, we argue the way I want to argue. You said there's a bro. So you made a mistake. Did you make a mistake? Okay, well, show me the contradiction. No, you need the Bible to show me the contradiction. You need the Bible, bro.
Come on.
Bible. Okay, so there's no contradiction. There's no contradiction. Do you take that back? Can you take it back?
No.
Okay, so what's the contradiction? What's the contradiction?
What I'm saying, contradiction.
What's the contradiction? So you want me to show you contradictions in the Quran?
Okay.
Take it out, brother.
Okay.
Take it out.
Don't say anything.
Take it out, bro.
I will answer you, but don't say
anything. Show him the two verses. Okay. So the Quran says this. The Quran says if we can find one contradiction in the Quran.
Okay,
now look, I told him there's a contradiction in the Quran, and I'm going to show you. I'm going to prove it. You told me there's a contradiction in the Bible, and you want the mic, not the Bible.
Okay. So first, hold on.
So first, what's it say?
First, we're going to go to the verse 482.
Okay, go to it.
Okay.
Verse 482 is going to say, if we can find one contradiction in the Quran, it's not from God.
Not
that's not the Quran. It says Quran. Read it anyway, bro. We know it's the Quran. That's malarkey. That's nonsense.
Nobody will understand you.
No, it's only, you know why it's not the Quran, bro? Because it says a whole bunch of horrible stuff that you don't want to own up to. That's why. It says a whole bunch of horrible stuff.
And the contradiction.
No, read it. Read it.
Those contradictions. Okay. I'll guide you.
Then do they not reflect? The print is too small.
What verse?
I can't see it.
It's lit up.
Oh, 82. 82, right?
Yeah.
Then do they not reflect upon the Quran? If it had been for any other than Allah, they would have found it within much contradiction. So any book that doesn't come from Allah has much contradiction. Now go to the next one. Now how long did it take to create the world?
You know what? You didn't answer me.
Okay, you don't want to listen. The Quran says two things. The Quran says it took 6 days to create the world, and then it says it took 8 days to create the world. Which one is true?
Six. It doesn't have to be six. In God's power.
No.
It's 6 years. 10, 3.
Takia! He's on that lion, bro! That's why it's so hard to reason with Muslims. Because when you start getting them, they start lying, bro. How many days? I'll let you talk, bro.
Just give me the mic.
You show me the contradiction. Show me the contradiction. You gonna show me the contradiction in the Bible?
I was telling you alone.
In the Taqiyya alone. Yeah.
Just the entire thing. Because you're not allowed to lie.
Amen. It's okay. It's okay. He's not even listening no more. Brother, listen to me. You said, it's just like this. If I say, oh, my wife is cheating on me. Where's the proof? That's what Muslims always say. Where's the proof? So, okay, if there's a contradiction in the Bible, where's the proof? Now, if you would like to humble yourself and say, I don't know, then we can move on. But if you're going to stay there, you got to show me the contradiction, bro. Stand still. Show me the contradiction. You can't. Where's the proof?
Preach.
God so loved the world that he gave us one. You need to repent, bro.
He
can't show me proof. The Bible says, unless you repent, you will like my parents. The Bible says, God so loved the world that he took his only begotten son, who believes in one of our parents, but heaven and our sons. The Bible says, God is calling all men everywhere to repent. The Bible says that unless you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you will not see God. Unless you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you will not get to heaven.
So God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
It's all about you.